today we're gonna teach you how to grind the grinding wheel. And then we got all the grinding pads, and they all have grit numbers on the back. See, this is grit 45. The lower the number, the stronger the grit. So they're all rather old, so I wouldn't say the grits are necessarily accurate. The older they get, the softer they get, but I kind of tell which one I want to use by how rough feels in my hand, and this is my favorite, most rough one if I have some real tough work to do. But perhaps if you don't have such rough grinding to do, you can use one of these slightly smoother ones. So I take my grit that I want, and then I check out my grinding situation. So we want to make sure there's water in here, and I do try to clean out any of this dust that's on the bottom of the bucket whenever I can. And this is where the water dumps out. And then we got our grinding pad. We want to that we are wearing glasses. And I also don't like the sound, so I always wear earmuffs as well. Now, to get it set up is pretty easy. I usually take two off, but you can take all of them off. You don't want any of these frilly things to get stuck under the pad, because they make a hump and then they throw off the centerness of the wheel. So I spend a good amount of time making sure it's clean. And it can kind of ruin the pad if you get a little chunk of glass stuck underneath, because once more it throws off the centerness of the wheel, and then when it spins it kind of pulls off. And I make sure it's on center for a while. Then I get everything on. And we're pretty much good to go. The thing about grinding, if you're doing some hardcore grinding, maybe consider wearing like a real mask. But I kind of don't go anywhere near this slip, and I don't go anywhere near here. I make sure the water's floating on the center, so everything stays wet. You don't want to see like a dry spot occur, because then you're heating up the glass and you're wearing down the pad. And I just go in little circles in the middle of the pad. Every once in a while, the table's a little shaky, and sometimes the grinding pad pulls off center, especially if you're using a rougher grit and you're trying to go down pretty far. So every once in a while, I do have to stop it and pull it back on center, and then let it continue going. If it's really far off center, sometimes the magnet will let loose, and this becomes a little bit of a flying saucer, which is pretty scary, I'm not gonna lie. Okay, so here we go. We're gonna use the rougher grit. I always make sure it's on center. Turn it on, turn the water on. My water thing's a little messed up, so I get it situated. Floating on the center, making sure the whole pad's getting wet. Then I grab the piece I wanna grind, hold on tight. Once in a while, I lift up to check what I'm doing, and then keep going. If the grinder pad's off center, then I pause, stop everything and fix it, but it sounds good. Ready to go. Make sure to turn the water off in between things, because it's a pain in the butt to refill.